I'm back. 2014 was, let's just say, a very interesting year for me personally. That's why, other than my convention visits, I haven't done a new episode in quite some time. But I'm back, and planning on doing at least one episode a month. And I'm also working on some other projects too, so definitely watch out for those. For my return episode, I thought I would take a movie that most fans of low-budget horror and exploitation seem to genuinely enjoy, and see if I can unceremoniously shit all over it. I'm talking about Burial Ground, a.k.a. The Nights of Terror. Not sure what it is about this genre that so many films have so many alternate titles, but anyway. We see this creepy old professor who kind of looks like Bugenhagen from The Omen translating some old writing.
I'm the only one who knows the secret.
He's the only one who knows what secret? Wait, if we knew, then he wouldn't be the only one, would he? Great. Now I'm critiquing myself. He goes down under the house he's in and starts banging on the wall loud enough to wake up the dead.
I don't have to wake him up. He's up.
No, no! Stand back! I'm your friend! No!
I'm your friend? That's a new approach. Most people in these movies, when confronted by the flesh-eating undead, either run or try to fight. Never seen someone attempt diplomacy before. Huh. How'd that work out for ya? 10 out of 10 for originality, but minus several million for good sense. A bunch of people arrive at the house and ask about the professor. Of course, he's nowhere to be found. We call this part of the movie Getting to Know Our Future Zombie Chow. This woman's son, Michael, even though small, looks kinda old to be a kid. And he's a creepy little fuck, too. But ass, so it's okay. Sex interrupted by zombie? Nope, creepy son with a voice far too deep for his age.
Mama.
Turns out the actor in this role is named Peter Bark, and he was a little person, which is why in most of the roles he plays somebody much younger than his actual years. In reality, this dude was about 25 when he made this movie, kind of like the guy who played Isaac in Children of the Corn, if you can believe it. Anyway, one of the women is creeped out by the place, but of course, no one in a horror flick ever listens to the person who instinctively knows all is not well in the kingdom. Otherwise, there'd be no movie. They look for the professor for a while.
You have any idea what it was you wanted to tell us?
Don't come. Zombies.
Let's split up. The zombies can kill us much more easily that way. For reasons that I assume are connected to the zombie infestation, although I really don't see how, the lights in the chandeliers start blowing up. Okay, cue the zombies. I sense a cheap jump scare here. Called it! My love, in the classic horror movie tradition, we have to fool around before we get killed. Meanwhile, little Michael is clearly jealous of his mom's man. Zombies aren't enough. We need an incest storyline too? Set phasers to creepy.
Aye, sir.
Okay, this zombie coming out of the ground is pretty well shot, and the makeup is actually pretty good for its time. If it were made today, though, those real maggots on the actor's face would be CGI. Why? 'Cause fuck that, that's why. The zombie is either gonna eat them, or maybe even join in the action. I've seen kinkier things in European horror movies. The couple runs off, and now suddenly it's Zombie-palooza!
Stenches in the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. And though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.
We're still in the first act here, and the place is already crawling with walking corpses. How do they plan to fill the next hour? A zombie walks in on Michael and company, and this guy tries to talk to it. We all saw how that worked out for the professor. Although he's armed, shooting the zombies in the head doesn't occur to him, so of course, he's zombie noms. Another zombie appears to one of the other couples. Why are they not running? Once I saw the hands coming up out of the ground, I'd be halfway to East Timbuk buttfuck by now. They finally gather the sense to run away, and why? Oh why? do women always fall in horror movies? I should do a video of top 10 most pointless horror movie falls. The blonde falls too, but because she got caught in a bear trap. Okay, at least there's a good reason for that fall, but why is that trap even there? Bears are the least of your worries in this fucking place. Everyone starts running back to the house, which is mysteriously locked from the inside. A zombie corners Michael and Mom, and... okay, diplomacy didn't work, so you're gonna try and paint the zombie to death? I'll give this movie credit for coming up with some pretty inventive, if idiotic, ways of dealing with zombies.
Oh, she's using it as an accelerant to light it on fire.
Guess I'm the asshole. This would be a great move if they weren't inside. What use is one dead zombie if you end up burning the joint down with you in it? Someone finally answers the damn door and everyone gets inside.
So long. I can't believe what's been happening. The lights came on, then there was a sudden surge of energy and all the bulbs started exploding and the whole electrical system broke down.
I would have punched this dude in the fucking face. Seriously? Exploding lights? How about you locked us outside with the living fucking dead?
Hey, fuck you, buddy!
They barricade themselves inside the house, but a maid finds a window open and investigates. These ninja zombies? Oh, and they're armed. Well, I'd call these people 50 Shades of Fucked. They behead the maid and proceed to do what zombies do best. One of the others finds her and is horrified. But apparently not so horrified that he doesn't throw them the rest of her? That is one of the most fucked up things I have ever seen. He knew this woman and actually sees these things eating her head as an appetizer and decides to personally serve them the main freaking course! The zombies start chopping and climbing their way into the house. In the midst of all of this, apparently, time for mother-son bad touch makeout time.
Oh, Mama, I love you so much. I need to feel you near me. I need to touch you. When I was a baby, you always used to hold me to your breast. I loved your breast so much, Mama.
Michael!
What's wrong? I'm your son!
Michael!
What's wrong? I'm your son? That is what's wrong, you little perv! Mommy goes looking for Michael and finds one of the others, now zombified, eating Michael's arm. I hate to say it, I really do, but this scene is almost humorous. Here is this woman mourning the death of her son while not 3 feet away, a zombie is eating some of him, looking just as happy as me with a bone-in steak. It's a little awkward and I'm sure unintentionally funny. Mommy takes care of zombie son eater while the others continue to try to evade the zombies that have overtaken the house. They find Mommy and find out Michael and the girl are...
Hey, they're gone. Split. Out of here. Afterlife kids. Deceased.
Someone's coming up from the basement. The professor from the opening scene. Huh. I guess he really is their friend now. The survivors of the group do what they should have done in the first place. They leave. They find a monastery and think they're safe, but guess what? Zombie monks. They keep running and hole up in some kind of workshop. Who wants to bet the zombies are there too?
Let's get back outside!
Doing the right dance, doing the right dance, doing the right dance. Zombie Michael shows up and of course Mommy is too stupid to realize he's a zombie and... Oh God. Okay, look. We all know what's coming, so let's just brace ourselves and get through it, okay? What did we learn today? Never let zombies near your pink parts. The zombies overwhelm them and that's it.
Everybody dies!
Although slow, low rent, and lacking in much character development, this movie really isn't all that bad.
But to be fair, you kind of have to be a fan of this kind of movie in the first place to really enjoy it. And I don't even mind the ending that much. I've always found horror movies scarier when evil actually wins. The only thing that pisses me off is we never find out why there are zombies in the first place. But to be fair, there are several zombie movies where we never find out the origin story. Bottom line, if you're a cheesy horror fan, I guess it's worth checking out once.